Good afternoon, and welcome to our Mass this afternoon. I am Paul Angelucci. I am the rector for today. Today's Mass is being offered for all the parishioners of the Holy Spirit Parish. The tabernacle lamp is lit for George Leone by Leones, Baubers, and Shannons. Today we celebrate the 28th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our celebrant for today's Mass is Father Mac and Deacon Dan. We ask at this time that you silence all electronic devices. Please be sure to take home a bulletin to keep up with events happening in our parish. CYO will meet next Sunday, October 13th. There will be a second collection next weekend for World Mission Sunday. Please be generous. And please join us downstairs after Mass for our Oktoberfest celebration. And at this time, please let us now stand and join each other in Christ.
Please let us join in singing our gathering song number 634.
Sister Annie Bremer's father was welcomed in to his eternal rest. So please, our sympathy to Sister, who is at this Mass, and her family, and let's please keep them in our prayers as we humbly come before the Lord, confident in his gift of everlasting life.
Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are seated at the right hand of the Father, intercede for us. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
To the man of God. On his arrival, he stood before Elisha and said, "Now I know there is no God in all the earth except in Israel. Please accept a gift from your servant." Elisha replied, "As the Lord lives, whom I serve, I will not take it." And despite Naaman's urging, he still refused. Naaman said, "If you will not accept, please let me, your servant, have 2 mule loads of earth, for I will no longer offer holocaust or sacrifice to any other god except to the Lord." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remember Jesus Christ, raised from the dead, a descendant of David. Such is my gospel, for which I am suffering, even to the point of chains, like a criminal. But the word of God is not chained. Therefore, I bear with everything for the sake of those who are chosen, so that they too may obtain the salvation that is in Christ Jesus, together with eternal glory. This saying is trustworthy. If we have died with him, we shall also live with him. If we persevere, we shall also reign with him. But if we deny him, he will deny us. If we are unfaithful, he remains unfaithful, for he cannot deny himself. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He traveled through Samaria and Galilee. As he was entering the village, 10 lepers met him. They stood at a distance from him and raised their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have pity on us." And when he saw them, he said, "Go, show yourselves to the priests." As they were going, they were cleansed. And one of them, realizing he had been healed, returned glorifying God in a loud voice, and he fell at the feet of Jesus and thanked him. He was a Samaritan. Jesus said in reply, "10 were cleansed, were they not? Where are the other 9? Has none but this foreigner returned to give thanks to God?" Then he said to him, "Stand up and go. Your faith has saved you." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
If you attend Mass on Thanksgiving, you'll notice that we normally read this Gospel because the theme of it seems to be that of Thanksgiving. Yet there's something that needs to occur before we can give thanks. And that is awareness. Awareness that we should be grateful. How many of you experienced the attacks on 9/11? You know the feeling on that day and the numbers of people that went to pray, filled the churches, and believe it or not, Capitol Hill gather together and pray. I doubt that that would happen today. Democrats and Republicans. Funny how the threat of destruction can cause people to act differently. Awareness of something bigger than what's on the surface. Now, these lepers could not approach Jesus. They had to stand at a distance. What did they want? They wanted healed so they could return to the community because they were estranged from the community. Notice something here. Jesus doesn't do what he normally does. Normally in the scripture, when he heals immediately. He did not do that. He sends them to show themselves to the priest. And on the way, they are cured. Sometimes God interacts in our lives on the way. We have to continue to trust and believe. It's not instantaneous. And then, when they get what they want, their physical healing, their return to the community, that's it. We don't need Jesus anymore. And so quickly, we can walk away from God. Remember the last time you were so scared to death, you prayed earnestly. Did the Lord answer your prayer? And how quickly we no longer pray. But this foreigner comes back aware of something more. Aware that God acted in his life. And because of this awareness, he is filled with gratitude. Every week, every day, but every week we gather to celebrate Eucharist, which is Thanksgiving. And yet how many people are really thankful? What do we usually do? Moan, groan, and complain. There's always something to gripe about. There's always something wrong. There's always some buffoon that's ruining our lives. How grateful are we? We can't be grateful. If we don't know, we should be grateful. If we're not aware of the blessings in our life. How many families sit down to a meal and for grace, they say, okay, we'll go around the table, tell us what you're grateful for. When was the last time you truly expressed your gratitude by name to God? Now these guys, they got what they wanted. But one who came back and thanked him, he got something far more. He didn't just get returned to the community. He entered into communion with God. He wasn't just physically healed. He received eternal life. God wants to offer you and me something more than we can even imagine. We pray for this, we pray for that, we want this, we want that. But what God wants to give us is always more. And when we're aware of that, we become receptive to the gift. Jesus intended salvation for all 10. But only one we know of actually received the gift the Lord really wanted to give him. And what does he tell him to do? get up and live the gift you have received. I remember being at the bedside of a dear person who was in a terrible car accident. Their twin brother died. They survived. They had survivor's guilt. And they were bemoaning and groaning and struggling. I kept in touch with this person for a number of years. And when the time was right, by the grace of God, I said to him, John, enough already about trying to understand what happened in the bigger plane. The fact is, you are alive. Question is, what are you doing with the gift you have been given? How do you honor your brother's memory? We can't go back. We can only go forward. And we can always go forward if we're aware that we're not alone, but we are all players in God's plan. And it's far bigger than any one of us. 9 received a gift and forfeited the ultimate gift. What about you? What about me? Are we aware of God in our life? I believe in one God, Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, life from life, God from God, begotten by the made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified on Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son for us and your plan for our eternal salvation as we place before you our cares and concerns.
Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for the church throughout the world and for all who seek the good news of the gospel. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those in political, civic, or judicial leadership. And for all who lead and work with them, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that through the intercession of our Blessed Mother, those who are struggling under the burden of doubt may have it lifted and replaced with a faithful yes to God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that we who hear the word may have the grace of the Holy Spirit to observe it in daily life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who have died and those who will die this day. We pray especially at this Mass for all living and deceased members of our parish. May God grant them salvation and joyful entry into his presence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now we pray for those special intentions that we hold in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us conclude by praying our parish prayer found in the hymn.
Lord Jesus, you told us where your treasure is, there your heart is also. The parish of Holy Spirit treasures our faith in you, our children, and every person who gathers here. Help us to have the courage to sacrifice, to love, and to build on your name. Guide us by your spirit of wisdom, give success to the work of our hands, and keep us in your peace. Saints, martyrs, and Mary, our mother, pray for us. Amen.
Please join in singing number 655, Increase Our Faith.
Just to pray, always.
You brought us back to be reconciled, O Lord, through your Son, who for our sake was handed over to a sentence of death. And now, celebrating the reconciliation we have in Christ, we pray that you send forth your Holy Spirit upon these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us body and blood of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. For when about to give his life to set us free, he reclined at supper. He took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith.
721 or 9.
And I always bless our little ones. I think we have us pray. We entreat your majesty most humbly, O Lord, that as you feed us with this nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, so you may make us heirs of his divine nature, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
And for any of you who may be staying and going down to have some of the Oktoberfest food, let us ask God's blessings upon the food and those who have prepared it. May it nourish us to serve you and one another always more faithfully, dear Lord, and above all, preserve us from indigestion. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and keep you, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Singing number 102, 102, Holy is your name.